I did some analysis on 500 dogs presenting with spinal disease to prove to my institution that a problem-based approach worked. And we took a load of data from these 500 dogs on their signalmen, their clinical exam, their neuro exam, their diagnostic tests, their imaging findings, and we did a raft of statistical analysis. And we found that actually just five simple variables could be associated with key spinal diseases. And so by taking into account the signalmen, the onset of the disease, the progression of the disease, whether it was asymmetrical or symmetrical in its neurological findings, whether it was painful, and finally the neurological localization itself, we found that by using this very simple logical approach, we could vastly improve the way that us as clinicians and our students were reaching a diagnosis. The five finger rule, as we call it, and we've typically used it as an approach to canine and feline spinal diseases, we've used it very much in-house, and we found that our graduates at the Royal Veterinary College take it with them into practice, and it's improved that the way they're approaching their neurology cases. It's almost like learning, if someone asked me to hit a golf ball with a golf club and just gave me a golf club, I can't do it. But if they break that down into a grip, a swing, a follow through, it makes life much easier. And that's what we're trying to do with the students, provide them with a framework that they can use to approach these cases that gives them confidence and helps them improve their diagnosis.